Worshipping with so many others around the world, and we're worshipping with the throng of angels singing beautifully, singing sweetly in the heavens, and our worship is joining that. But I also want to say that the Lord invites us to enter His throne room. He invites us to enter and stand before His throne of grace and mercy this morning. And I want to encourage you right now, just to take a minute, and avail yourself of His mercy. We want to come with our hearts having been cleansed with that water of life, just to take a moment right now, say, Holy Spirit, prompt me. What is it that I need to confess to you right now? What is it that's burdening me? Ask for forgiveness. Ask for cleansing. Lord, we thank you. That door in heaven stands open. You're ushering us in right now through the blood of Jesus. His death and His resurrection to stand before you. Oh Jesus, we thank you for that new and living way that you've opened up. Here we are, Lord. We bring our thanks. We bring our grateful hearts. We position our hearts to see you. Stir us, Holy Spirit. Come and fill us. And as we open our mouths to worship, Lord, come and fill this place. Manifest, Holy Spirit, the presence of Jesus. Manifest His presence. Worship, adoration. Lord, you're worthy. you're so worthy. Every good gift that we have has come from you. Glorious God and Father, we worship you. We worship you. We lift your name. There's no other name but the name of Jesus by which we can be saved. We're here this morning, Lord, to worship you, to give you thanks, to fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith. Here we are, Lord. Here we are, Lord. We lift up our hungry hearts, Lord. We lift up our heavy heads to see the King of Glory, to see the God of beauty and the God of glory and majesty. What a privilege, Lord, to stand here today to worship you. Oh, we worship you, Lord. Yes, we will sing. Yes, we will say that there's no other name. There's no other God, and great is the Lord, and greatly to be worshipped and praised. Thanksgiving, honor, and power belongs to you. Yeah, come on, lift your voices. Your throne is glorious, God. We enter your presence. We enter your gates with thanksgiving. Oh, with a right perspective. Oh, to see you, Jesus, high and lifted up. High and lifted up, glorious one. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name. Yeah. Worthy is your name. Holy is the name. Holy is the name. How beautiful is the one seated in majesty, power, glory, and honor forever and ever and ever. Amen. Yeah. Yeah, Lord. We worship you and praise you. Worship you and praise you. Yeah. Come on, everyone. Lift your voices. He's worthy. If you don't know what to sing, open your scriptures. Open up the Word of God and begin to speak it out. Lift up your heads, you gates. Yeah, he's worthy. Come on, join the worship team. Let's sing it together.
Lamb who was slain. His foes will be silenced. He's fighting for Zion. There's no other God like Jehovah, Jehovah. He's never tired. His eyes are like fire. There's no other God like Jehovah, Jehovah. Call the name, call the name, call the name, Jehovah. All our praise, belongs to Him. Call the
Jehovah Nissi fights your battles. Jehovah Nissi fights your battles. Jehovah Nissi fights your battles. This is who you are. Jehovah Nissi fights your battles. Jehovah Nissi fights your battles. Oh, Jehovah Nissi fights your battles.
The Lord is a banner over us.
Jehovah Nissi fights your battles. Jehovah Nissi fights your battles. Jehovah Jireh meets your needs. Jehovah Rapha, heal your body. Jehovah Shalom, be your peace. Jehovah Nissi fights your battles. Jehovah Jireh meets your needs. Jehovah Rapha. Jehovah Nissi fights your battles.
We lift you high.
Jehovah Jireh meets your need.
We declare the truth.
Jehovah Rapha, heal your body.
Oh.
Jehovah Shalom, be your peace. Call the name, call the name, call the name, Jehovah. Oh.
Jehovah Rapha, heal your body. Jehovah Shalom, be your peace. Jehovah Nisi, fight your battle. Jehovah Jireh, meets your knees.
This is who you are.
Jehovah Rapha, heal your body. Jehovah Shalom, be your peace.
Jehovah
Nisi, fight your battle.
Oh, the Lord, the Lord.
Jehovah Jireh meets your need.
Gracious and compassionate.
Jehovah Rapha, heal your body.
This is who you are.
Jehovah Shalom, be your peace.
Call the name.
Call the name. Call the name. Call the name. Jehovah. All our praise belongs to Him.
Call the name, call the name,
call the name, Jehovah. All our praise, belongs to Him. Thank you.
Your Praise your eyes to you in your throne. let our praise arise to you, your throne. Let our praise arise to you, let our praise arise to you, let our praise arise to you on your throne.
Pleasing fragrance and incense,
let our praise arise to you, let our praise arise to you, let our praise arise to you on your throne.
Show you what must take place after this. And once I was in the spirit, and there before me was a throne in heaven with someone sitting on it, and the one who sat there had the appearance of jasper and ruby. Stand. Stand in the presence of a holy and awesome God, seated on a glorious throne. We come through that open door, opened up by your blood, Lord Jesus. Welcomed in, invited to see, invited into the place of encounter. Encounter with the divine, heavenly, eternal, glorious, majestic God of heaven and earth, the creator God of all things, who was and who is to come, the one the angels cry out, holy, the one that the four living creatures surround the throne. Never ceasing to say, holy, he's holy. He's holy. Heaven and earth, he's holy. He's the Lord God Almighty. The Alpha and the Omega, the one who is and the one who is to come, and the one who was, the one without end, without beginning, the eternal, blazing, fiery God of jasper and ruby. Dazzling splendor, the one that shines like a diamond. Every facet a different color. Glorious and radiant, you are holy, God. The carnelian, the ruby red gemstone, the passionate God we see as John saw, the colors, the red that speaks of your burning passion, your desire, your holy desire, your holy jealousy, for you are Creator God. You've created us in your image. You are jealous for the restoration and the redemption of all creation. We stand in your presence, God. Holy. 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 Holy and high is your throne, sovereign God. There is no other throne. There is no other throne. No other worthy of worship. No other worthy of the fear, the awesome, the trembling of our hearts. No other to be worshipped. And you've invited us to come close. Holy God. Holy. Sovereign, the great I am. Glory, honor, and power belongs to you, and there is no other. For from you, and to you, and for you are all things created. By your will, created. By your will, they have their being. You, God, and only you.
Thank you.
cause us to tremble in your presence, Lord. Open our eyes to see the holy, the holy. Your invitation, Lord, this morning. To see you, to behold you, is to know you, is to be transformed from glory to glory. Lord, we want to be transformed. We want our whole being to see, to know, to respond, and to worship you. Catch us up. Catch us up as we rest here a moment. Open up a vision of your beauty to our spirits, spirit to spirit, Lord. We want to see the glory, the beauty, the dazzling splendor, to hear the thunder, to see the flashes, Lord, the lightning around your throne, the emerald rainbow. Oh, you're faithful, God. Thank you. worship you, the beauty of your holiness, Lord. The beauty of your holiness, Jesus. God of glory. Sing holy.
Holy. Lord God Almighty. Holy. Holy. Lord God Almighty. Holy.
You are holy, Lord God.
Holy.
Holy and glorious are you.
Lord God Almighty.
Who is like you, God?
Holy.
In all the heavens and all the earth, holy. And under the earth, there is no other name.
Lord God,
there is no
Almighty.
Other name but the name of our great God. Holy is He.
Holy.
Holy is He.
Holy. Lord God Almighty. Yeah. Holy. Holy.
Of splendor. and ever. Amen. All the worship, all the honor, every knee bowing, from every tongue and every tribe and every nation, every knee will bow and declare that you are the God of glory and Jesus, the King of kings, the Lord of lords. Oh, we lift it up this morning. We declare it this morning. What a privilege to declare it this morning, to sing back from heaven, to sing back to the songs of heaven, from the earth, to lift our voices from the earth, to join the chorus in the heavens. Oh, Lord.
Kadosh, oh Kadosh, Kadosh. thousands upon thousands of you.
Holy,
never stop singing.
Holy, holy.
There is no boredom in your presence. Holy, yeah.
Holy, holy, holy.
God of infinite beauty. Can't wait for that day to see you face to face and to join the four living creatures around your throne and to gaze on your infinite beauty, God. To be mesmerized by you for all eternity. To never get tired of saying, holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. We bless you to this day, God. Thank you for glimpses you've given us. Thank you for the glimpses that you give us of your infinite beauty. Thank you for the mystery and the wonder of your beauty and your glory on the cross as you laid down your life. Jesus, you willingly suffered and bled and died to redeem all of us who were your enemies, that we could become restored. We could be restored into your eternal family, to have our hearts filled with hope in the midst of strife and difficulties of this life. A God of infinite beauty, continue to speak to us. Sit down if you haven't sat already. We are moving into a time around the Feast of Jesus, so you might want to get your little cup ready, but we're not there just yet, so you might want to one of the things that we have consistently done as New Life Church is spend extended time in Revelation chapter 4. And one of the things that we've encouraged people to do over the years, and I want to say it again this morning, I want to encourage you, if you have never done a 40-day soaking in Revelation chapter 4, today would be a great day to begin that. And what I mean by that is that actually, you read out loud Revelation chapter 4 three times a day for 40 days. Revelation chapter 4 three times a day for 40 days. What you'll find is you'll be transformed on the inside. It will change the way you see God, and therefore it will change the way you pray, and it will change the way that you live. So if you've never done the Revelation 4 40-day challenge, I want to encourage you to start today. Three times a day. How many meals do you eat a day? Don't answer that. But typically we eat morning, noon and night. We wake up, we eat. Middle of the day, evening, we eat. If you do Revelation 4 at every meal for 40 days, you'll get through it and it'll transform you. So I encourage you to do that. This morning, as Julie and I were praying together at home and preparing for today, we felt like the Lord highlighted a prophetic word that was given to us by a member of the congregation 25 years ago in 1999. This person's no longer with us. We think they've gone to glory. We want to share a little bit of that word for you. So I just invite you to listen. The Lord says, I hear you say to me, Lord, we want more of your love, mercy, grace. We want more of your anointing, more of your glory, and all these you will have. And I have said to you, deny yourself, take up your cross and follow me. You want more of me, but I want all of you. I want you to surrender to me your ideas, your plans, your dreams, your visions, your agendas, your philosophies of life, your relationships, your money, your degrees, your intellect, your skills, your relationships, your sexuality, your material possessions, your money, your houses, your cars, your technology, your time. Yes, your very self. Nothing in my scriptures speaks of an easy time. A victorious time, yes, but not easy. King David, my servant, knew that in walking through and not around the valley of the shadow of death, he would fear no evil, for I was with him. And neither should you fear, for I am with you. My spirit lives in you. Do not lose hope when you are tried by fire. I purge you out of love to take the dross away, to bring forth pure gold, a symbol of my glory. Only melted gold is useful. Only moistened clay receives the mold. Only softened wax receives the seal. Only broken, contrite hearts receive the mark of the potter as he turns you on his wheel. And transitioning to Acts 10 and reading from verse 34, and Peter is in the house of Cornelius, the Roman centurion. And Peter says, I see very clearly that God shows no favoritism. In every nation, he accepts those who fear him and do what is right. This is the message of good news for the people of Israel, that there is peace with God through Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. You know what happened throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee, after John began preaching his message of baptism. And you know that God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. Then Jesus went around doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. And we apostles are witnesses of all he did throughout Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a cross. But God raised him to life on the third day. Then God allowed him to appear, not to the general public, but to us whom God had chosen in advance to be his witnesses. We were those who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. And he ordered us to preach everywhere and to testify that Jesus is the one appointed by God to be the judge of all, the living and the dead. He is the one all the prophets testified about, saying that everyone who believes in him will have their sins forgiven through his name. In that prophetic word that I shared, and in the scripture that's just read, of course, the theme that comes through over and over is the Lordship of Jesus. And before we eat and drink today, I want us to pray a Lordship prayer together, and the words are going to come up on the screen, and I'm going to ask you to stand as we pray this together, everybody. Let's pray together. Eternal God, I submit myself wholeheartedly to Jesus Christ as Lord of my whole being, Lord of my spirit and all my spiritual beliefs, interaction and worship, Lord of my mind, my attitudes, my thinking, my beliefs and my imagination, Lord of my emotions and my expression of my feelings, Lord of my will and all my decisions. Lord of my body, physical health, exercise, diet, my rest and my appearance. Lord of my sexuality and its expression. Lord of my family and all my relationships. Lord of my paid work and volunteer. military service. Lord of my possessions and what I think I need. Lord of my finances. Lord of my plans, my ambitions, and my future. Jesus, thank you that you laid down your life and suffered in my place to free me from the consequences of my sin, iniquity, and rebellion. And now I am free to love, worship, and obey you with all my heart, soul, mind, and strength. Jesus, you are the true Lord of all creation, and I willingly submit my whole being completely to you today and forever. Amen. And let's remain standing. And first of all, eat the wafer that represents the body of Christ that was crucified for us, one who died in our place. I invite you just to take the layer off the juice, not drink it yet, but actually look at it. Whisper your own prayer of thankfulness for Jesus, that he was willing to give his blood to cleanse you from your sin so that you could be restored to God, to the family of God, and have an eternal hope and future. Give thanks to Jesus that you belong to the family of God. Give thanks to Jesus for the reality that to all who believe in him, he gives the right to become children of God. As children of God, let us eat and drink together. We praise you, Jesus, and thank you. Amen.
I want to give a time for people to receive prayer for healing.
Cups to the fit team.
Yeah, the cups will be collected as you begin to respond to this. I just want to encourage you, if you need prayer for healing, thinking physical healing or emotional healing, the Lord has been gracious to manifest his presence with us this morning, and he's been touching us and stirring our hearts to respond and make him Lord. Just declare that again and say, Holy Spirit, I need your help to do this. But I want to read from Isaiah 53. It said, when Jesus suffered and bled, he took up our pain and he bore our suffering. He was stricken. We considered him punished by God. But he was actually pierced for our transgressions, and he was crushed for our iniquities. And the punishment that brought us peace was on him. And by his wounds, we are healed. Can you say that? By his wounds, we are healed. There's an eternal healing. There's an eternal wholeness. We call that salvation, wholeness and healing. But Jesus, our healer, wore walks among us right now. He's here, and so we want to ask him. If you'd like prayer for healing, you can just step into the aisle or you can come down the front. We're going to form a T-shape this morning. We're just going to take a few minutes. The Lord is here. He may have already touched your body with healing. If you want prayer this morning, just please respond quickly down the front or in the aisle. And those of you, house church leaders, the board, leaders, come and pray. Just begin. I'm going to pray. Wayne's going to anoint with oil. Just move around. Take a few minutes. And worship team, if you can just quietly sing. I don't mind if you just sing your own song just quietly to the Lord, or lead us in a chorus. But we're just so thankful, Lord Jesus, for your presence in this place today. So thankful, Lord. And I know, Lord, that it blesses your heart when we respond. You give grace to the humble. And Lord, we are broken. We are broken people. We live in a broken and fallen world. And there's all kinds of needs that we have. And Jesus, that's why you came. That's exactly why you came. So we ask you right now, Jehovah Rapha, our healer, to walk among us right now. Just as people are standing, Jesus, you saw the crowds. You looked crowds and crowds of people, and your heart was full of loving kindness, compassion, like real passion. You looked at the afflicted and you were full of compassion. When you stretched out your hand, people were healed. And you asked them what it was that they wanted. You knew what they wanted, but you wanted them to speak it. And I just encourage you right now, as you're standing there, and people sitting down, just begin to pray. Or you can stand and begin to walk around and say, Lord, touch. Touch our hearts. Touch our bodies. Touch our minds, our emotions, Lord. Bring healing. Yeah. Perhaps if you're standing next to someone and they're not being prayed for, just turn to them and just pray the Lord's blessing of healing on their lives right now. Yeah. Just begin. If you see someone, you can pray for them. Come and pray for them. Jesus. Right now, Lord, you're looking at emotions locked up, Lord. You're wanting to release captives imprisoned, Lord, in those dark places. Jesus, raise your sword and cut through every lie, every hindrance. Lord, break off the heavy yoke. Here we are, Lord, and you are here. Thank you that you walk around us right now, touching. Just stretch out your hand, Lord. Stretch out your hand. Jesus, your name is healing. Your name is healing. Go to the deepest place.
The God Almighty.
Set every prison door open, Lord. Set it open. Pull it open right now, Lord. Lift up. Lift up. Lord, lift up out of that pit, Lord. Places where our minds and hearts have been trapped through traumas and just different things, Lord. Woundings in our minds, Lord. We look to you right now. Jesus. Jesus. Uproot every lie, Lord. Truth encounters today, Lord Jesus. Truth encounters. Blessing.
Lord God Almighty. Holy. Holy. Lord God Almighty.
Highlighting people who have experienced grief and loss of different kinds, and there's a lament in your soul that is so difficult to utter or even to identify. And the Lord is saying that He sees and He knows. He knows when that wounding came in and when that brokenness happened, and just to say that He's mindful of you and He's healing you now. He's present to heal you, and He's heard your laments, He's heard your deep cries. Thank
you. Jesus, thank you. Thank you. You know us better than we know ourselves, and you know the hidden place, Lord, the hidden place of our pain, the hidden place of tears, the cry in people's hearts. Thank you for bringing release, Lord Jesus. Yeah. We thank you, Lord. Thank you for this morning. We thank you that you've met us as we have fixed our gaze on things above, Lord, where you are seated in power and glory. We thank you, God. Thank you for perspective, Lord, this morning. Thank you for the release of your presence as we've worshiped. And Lord, we want to go out with a song that, an anthem that declares that you're holy, seated above. Beautiful song. Lord, we worship you as we leave this place today. Holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Jesus, would you continue to do this great work in our hearts? Continue, Lord, to touch us. Even in this final song, as we're worshiping, Lord, would you release your presence and your power and your glory. Amen. Let's stand together. Thanks, Nathan.
Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Holy, holy is He. Sing a new song to Him who sits on heaven's mercy seat. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With the creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore You.
I will adore You.
Clothed in rainbows of living colors, flashes of lightning, rolls of thunder. Blessing and honor, strength and glory and power be to You, the only wise King. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was
been our joy this morning to host Your presence, to connect with Your heart, to release Your power, and to see You move in our midst. And Lord, we're asking for more and more and more and more of You in our midst, doing wonderful things like this morning. God, we want to get lost in Your presence, lost in Your power, lost in Your glory, and become the found ones in that place who help the world become found in You. So Lord, keep filling us with Your glory, keep filling us with Your power, keep releasing us back into our families and our communities, that we would bring You glory and honor in everything we do. Amen. That does bring our Sunday morning to a close, but I do want to run through some announcements. They've been saved to the end so that we could just stay in that place of worship. So next Sunday, Resurrection Sunday, a very exciting Sunday. Jesus got out of that grave with power and glory, and we remember Him And I believe God is releasing resurrection power in our community even today with healing and life and joy. And let's be praying for that release of His resurrection life and power, the same power that raised Christ from the dead lives in us. And let's also start that when we arrive by parking at the top, if you can, and use that resurrection power to walk down the hill, because it is our dedication, parent-child dedication. So there will be some extra family members here. There will be some extra guests here. So if you can park at the top, if you're able to, obviously if you need to park down here, by all means do. But if you are able to, please park up the top. It's also our financial gift for the Israel serving team. So we're sending a team of, what's the number? 10? 11. There's 11 who are going over to Israel to serve, and we want to bless them financially because some of them are taking time off work. Some of them it's paid leave. Some of them it's unpaid leave. There's all sorts of financial situations in there and costs on the trip. So we want to bless that team and send them in strength from this community. So be praying about that. Bring that, stay after Sunday for morning tea, and we've got the coffee van if your age is 16 and over. There will be an ID check, 16 and over only, and we want to make sure we're getting those to the right people. And children are going to be invited to come and sit at the front on the mat. It's going to be very exciting. There's a wonderful mat up here for all the children, and that's one of the ways we're going to free up some seats for our guests next Sunday. So that means baptisms are not happening next Sunday. They have been rescheduled to the 14th of April. Okay, so baptisms have been moved back a couple of weeks. So if you've been thinking about baptism and you haven't done anything with it, please email us or reach out to one of our lead pastors or email info@newlifefremantle.com to register your interest. And the last announcement is we are entering what we call our Passover season. And there are daily readings and booklets that come along with that. So you've probably had those in previous seasons. If you hadn't, it's a very, very useful prayer tool and prayer guide for you as a family to gather around. Now, they will be emailed to all of you who are on the email list. If you're not on the email list, again, info@newlifefremantle.com, and you can get on that list. But if you want the hard copy, we are doing a printing run of hard copies. You need to register for that this morning. This is our last chance to register for that, and it's $5. Please speak to the QR code on the screen. Speak to it. Talk to it and just tell it what you need, and it will deliver for you. No, so just go there and register. You can pay your $5, and we'll get those hard copies coming to you. But the free ones are still coming. There's recordings again of like the daily podcast. We're doing all that stuff again. So it's going to be a really great season. Lots of ways to engage in it. Lots of opportunities to strengthen your faith and knowledge of God. Please take advantage of it. And if you do want that hard copy, register today. Wayne, are you... We're not. We are worshiping. We are going out in song. Thank you, Nathan and the team.
All right. I don't have much voice left, but let's go.
Oh, you are holy.
Thank you, God, for your kindness to us today, for drawing near to us. We ask for more. Amen. Go enjoy the rest of your day and carry with you the holiness of God as you go.